Okay, welcome everybody to the webcast on less complex entities. My name is Roger Simnett. I am the IAASB board member and the Less Complex Entities Working Chair. The aim today is to work you through the discussion paper which we have released on less complex entities. There is actually a lot in this title. Before I slide off this title, we are concentrating on the audits of less complex entities, as I will explain, even though there are other levels of assurance and assurance provision. We will concentrate on the audit elements of it so that we can see as an IAASB collective what we need to do in that particular area. We've also titled this Less Complex Entities as distinct from SMEs. And again, I will walk you through the logic of why we have done that. So welcome to everybody to this webcast. I am aware that it is 5 a.m. for some of you, 11 p.m. for those of you in New Zealand. So we'll keep you entertained for the next hour. Next slide, thank you. Okay, let me step you through the IAASB's journey to date. We have been paying attention to this particular issue. It has been high on our agenda since the IAASB was formed in 2002. So I'll just take you through this particular roadmap. As you can see, in 2002 to 2009, we worked through our Clarity project to try and ensure that the auditing standards were clear and concise to aid audit quality. So there was a clarification project as part of the redraft. In the application material, separate paragraphs were added to focus considerations for smaller entities, and these still remain in the ICES today. The post-implementation review of the clarified ICES included a specific focus on the impact of applying the new and revised ICES for audits of SMEs through a survey carried out over 2 years. The findings from the survey found that the introduction of the clarified ICES had a positive impact on the work, in particular in relation to audit quality and to quality control. There was also more focus on risk, and it was also noted that this helped the recommendations made to management. However, at this time, it was also noted that documentation was an issue. This feedback, together with other things that we have learned along our journey, have informed many of the projects we are doing today. In early 2015, we formed an informal group at the IAASB to look into the issues related to the audits of SMEs. This group eventually morphed into the current working group, who are now considering these matters. In 2017, we arranged our first global conference in Paris. Thank you very much to the organisations from France, which included both audits and other services. We gained much information from that conference. It was well attended from people from over 23 countries. In 2018, the IAASB discussed the work of its informal working group, as well as the matters discussed at the Paris conference in an executive session, and agreed to more formally establish a working group to gather information about what should be done. This working group has developed the discussion paper we'll explain in this webcast, and also arranged a second working conference in Paris to discuss at the May Paris conference this year. Discussions and views expressed in Paris are going to be combined with the responses to the more formal consultation, as well as a survey, as we try and work a best way forward from the IAASB's perspective. So on the basis of this, you can see that we have continued to think about issues associated with the SME community from a less complex entity perspective. We always think about these things as we write our standards, and we think about scalability and proportionality in those particular standards. However, as we will discuss, we have been challenged on the scalability and proportionality, especially with some of the new standards that has come out. We would love to ensure that, and we, one of the reasons why we're doing this webinar is to reach out to a constituency that we don't directly engage with. Certainly we get the views of the SMEs through the IFAC SMP community, but we would love to hear from you directly. That is why you can see the format of the discussion paper which we are discussing today. It has been written very much in a format to engage with the particular community we'd like to. We believe it is very readable. We've had good comments on the readability of the document, and so I would encourage you to read this discussion paper as we work through it. Next slide, please. So the discussion paper which we're talking about, Audits of Less Complex Entities, Exploring Possible Options to Address the Challenges in Applying the ISAs. So as I said, we are concentrating on audits. We do recognise that there are a range of solutions out there in the forms of other assurance engagements, but we are really concentrating at this stage on those areas where an audit is required. The discussion paper was published in April 29th, 2019, and we're looking for comments in any form that you wish to send them in by September the 12th, 2019. This is a discussion paper. We will take the results from this. It is the research phase of this particular area. We will take the results. We will feed that into the IAASB to determine the future course of action. We remain open-minded. And so there has been nothing closed out, and there has been nothing that is left off the agenda. We have tried to ensure a complete paper which picks up the range of alternatives to the IAASB. Next slide, please. In fact, we have a poll question. Can we put up the poll question, please? And I'll give you some time to answer this. And we're trying to find who stakeholders groups you probably represent. So Amanda, I'll leave you to give an appropriate time. Thanks, Amand. Okay, we have a range of representatives, and good to see that we've got so many from public practice. And we would love to hear from all groups, including other. But thank you very much. We can see that we have a range of areas there. Next slide, please. Okay, the first issue that I talked about is what is a less complex entity. And so we've moved from SME to less complex entity on the basis that we have identified on the issue of scalability and proportionality that the auditing standards are scalable on the basis of risk. And risk relates much more to complexity than it does to size. So in that particular area, we have taken this area to see what it is. We are looking for feedback. There is a question in the discussion paper, which is to seeing if this picks up the elements of the less complex entity. And so what we have here is the definition, which has actually been applied to SMEs. And that we have taken that definition across in its entirety, rather than changing things at the moment, because we do recognise that parts of this definition at least come across as less complex entities. We'd love to hear your feedback on this area. This definition will become important, especially for some of the potential alternatives that we are discussing today. If it is only scalability and proportionality of the auditing standards suite as we see it today, then it should not matter as very much as to what this definition would be if we can get the scalability and proportionality right. However, if we go down the track of a single standard for less complex entities or specific guidance for less complex entities, then we're going to have a way of determining who can use that single standard or who that guidance is aimed for. So as we say, these qualitative characteristics are not exhaustive or exclusive. And so we would love to get feedback on those particular characteristics. Let's go on to the next part of the discussion paper. Thank you. So in this area, we've identified the challenges related to applying the ISAs in the audits of the LCEs. And we're really trying to get to the root cause. So we're trying to get as much information as we can as to the root cause, as to the problems out there, so that we can then address those particular problems. We have broken these challenges into groups. And the first is those challenges which are not within the IAASB's control or are scoped out on the audits. So those factors which are not within the IAASB's controls, as you can see in the blue box, if you've got colour, include legal and other requirements of an audit. Commercial considerations related to the audit, including the value of the audit. Technology solutions and education requirements and the people involved in the particular audit. Although these are particular issues that may drive quality of audits in the SME LCE space, they are not factors that are within the control of the IAASB. It does not mean that we ignore them. We'd love to get feedback on these, but it would mean that other people or the IAASB working with other people would be the way that we go. If we go over to the right, we can also see that there are engagements which are scoped out of the characteristics of the audits of the LCE. So these are engagements other than audit, and this includes reviews or agreed upon procedures or some hybrid situation. We realise that they may be potential solutions again, but we have to get our requirements right for audit, as distinct from then requiring it to look at how we deal with other types of engagements. Enhanced accessibility of the ISAs. Again, we recognise that in the current technology work world, we can deal better with how we can aid the accessibility of the ISAs, the searchability of the ISAs, and we are attempting to deal with that. But again, it's not within the remit of the IAASB, which is a standard setting board, but we do see it as a part of the potential solution. The value of an audit, and there have been many comments around the world regarding the value of an audit, and comments and criticisms as to whether or not the value of the audit is being maintained in the current world. And again, public's expectations. All of these are important areas that we need to address. As I've said, we will not completely ignore these. They obviously play an important role in the environment. And the IAASB will think more about how it can influence others to address some of these particular issues in order to ensure that we increase the quality of audits in the SME space. Let's go to the next slide, thank you. Another poll question. Again, I'll give you a minute or two to answer this. And we're very interested in finding out whether in your jurisdiction, there are questions currently being asked about the value of an audit and the results. As we can see, 71% have said there are questions being asked about the value of the audit in their jurisdiction. In some jurisdictions, or from the perspectives of some of the people on the call today, there are none, and there's a few who don't know. But certainly these are issues that we are looking at addressing from the IAASB's perspective. And again, a lot of the solutions may fall outside the remit of the IAASB. It doesn't mean we ignore them. We have to work out how best to help take these forward. Thank you. Let's go on to the next area. So we're now getting into the stage of the document which outlines the challenges relating to applying the ISAs in the audits of less complex entities. And see that these are challenges that are within scope of the IAASB's work. So these are things that are within the IAASB's remit. And we've outlined a few of these areas. One of these is the language and the basic approach to the standards, and these are spelled out, each of these are spelled out in more detail in the discussion paper, so I'd encourage people to go back and read it. So as I outlined at the beginning of this webinar, we did go through a clarity process, and it is possible that from the clarity process, which ended in 2009 and with standards going through to 2013, that the current language and basic approach to the standards, we've lost some of the clarity. Some of our sentences have become complex. The length of the standards. We are getting much feedback on the increased length of and complexity of the current standards which we are issuing, being necessary to deal with an increasingly complex world from the accounting perspectives as well. We have had feedback at the IAASB on recent standards we have issued. 540 on audit of accounting estimates was a significantly longer standard than the extant 540. And we are going through the process of feedback on 315. And again, we've received a lot of feedback on 315. Our assessment of risk standards as to the current length. And we are trying to deal with those comments. So we are trying to deal with this, but we recognise the length of the standards. We also recognise documentation requirements, which are extensive and are becoming more onerous. And so again, there can be issues with documentation, which we understand is taking up a large percentage of audit work for SMEs. There can be issues with documentation about a lack of clarity about what needs to be documented and the extent thereof when auditing LCEs. So we'll look at the documentation. Within the requirements, there can be there is concerns or a challenge as to whether we are clearly specifying what needs to be done or why in the specific circumstances of the engagement. So is there enough clarity in the requirements so that they are scalable and proportional to the less complex entity that you need to audit? And so again, we are looking at issues in that particular regard. We're also being questioned or challenged on whether or not there is enough guidance within the ISAs in the forms of application material or other forms of guidance, or outside the ISAs in other forms of guidance. It is an interesting dilemma because if we add additional specific application material for SMEs, that again increases the length of the standards. And we do see that the length is becoming particularly problematic. We have to have the standards that people are going to pick them up and read them, or in some way digest what they are expected to do as far as the requirements in order to improve audit clarity in this particular regard. And we've also been given notice that there are specific ISAs which are particularly problematic. I won't outline what those ones are. Some of those are outlined in the discussion paper. But we'd love to receive some feedback on issues as far as ICERs, which are particularly problematic. If we can identify the ICERs which are problematic, we can try and deal with those. But again, this is root cause analysis. So we need the feedback from the broad constituency around the world so that we can hear your views as to what is particularly problematic. So again, there are questions which are aimed at those particular challenges. Thank you. Next slide. So within the discussion paper, what are the possible actions to be explored? And within the discussion paper, we have not tried to exclude any particular options. We haven't set on we haven't settled on an option, but we have not excluded any particular option. So you'll see we take us through the three particular options. They are the revising of the ICERs, and we'll do that on this slide, developing a separate auditing standard for audits of less complex entities, and developing guidance for auditors of less complex entities. Now, that is the entire population of potential solutions and ways that the IAASB can deal with the issues of trying to ensure that we have clarity on the ICERs as far as concern for less complex entities. So let me take you through each of these particular options. Firstly, the revising of the option, revising of the ICERs. And so we will do this by trying to provide greater clarity on what the auditor needs to do. So if there is a lack of clarity through the language we've used, through the length of the standards, or through any other particular process, we need to know those. We can do that by setting out the basic requirements and then building on those for more complex situations. So again, it's a matter of pitching the setting of the ICERs at a particular level and not too complex, not the most basic, but not too complex, and then using a building box approach to how we can build the ICERs in order to deal with more complex issues. And we can also look at enhancing scalability considerations in the application material. So again, we can provide further guidance for the auditors on exactly the scalability and proportionality, how you get it, or whether you're into particular requirements or not, and how we can best do that. So how do we go about doing that? This could involve revising all of the ICERs as part of one substantial project, very similar to the Clarity project. This is going to be a fairly, if we go this particular route, this is going to be fairly resource intensive. The Clarity project did take a lot of resources from the IAASB. And if you have a look at the strategy document, which the IAASB has released recently for discussion and is currently working through, you'll see that the work program for the IAASB is already fairly full for the next couple of years. It could involve revising the ICERs on a rolling or a phased basis. So if we can get details on exactly which ICERs are causing the most problems and exactly within which ICERs those problems are occurring, then we can do that. And so that again covers off the targeted changes when an ICER is being revised. The more and exact details we can get as to the areas or the requirements which are giving rise to concerns as far as auditing of LCEs, the better we can be at trying to address those particular changes. Okay, let's go to the next slide, please. Okay, our second range of options is developing a separate auditing standard for the audits of less complex entities. And again, it's important to remind you that we are only at the thinking stage. So we have the full range of options here, and we are thinking about that. A lot of work has been done in this, originally by the Nordic Federation, who did quite a lot of work and set out a pro forma as to what this could look like. As we work around the world in the current environment, and as we in our lead up to the Paris conference, which was held in May this year, we also found that there was a number of national standard setters who have started to go down this route. And this includes the French, the Belgians, the Sri Lankans, for example, being some of those. Now, that's not necessarily, each of the national standard setters is not necessarily the best approach to an international problem, especially if the national standard setters are addressing this differently from their national areas. If we can take this and get the feedback on this particular areas so that we can address this from an international perspective, that again is much better international solution. So much better that this is being driven internationally than we see the ranges out there. So separate auditing standard based on the requirements which are contained in the existing ISAs, or it could be a separate auditing standard which is developed based on a different framework, and we don't necessarily have a framework in mind, but something different to our risk-based type of framework, which is sitting in our audit, which works off our current suite of auditing standards. So for example, it could be a much more substantive approach to an audit as a possibility. So again, this is a possible actions that could be explored, and it is a range of the solutions. We would like to get your feedback on whether this is an approach which we at the IAASB should consider. Let us take the next poll question. Okay, so we're asking about, has there been discussions in your jurisdiction about addressing complexity of the ISAs by introducing a regional initiative? So are you aware of something which is going on in your region currently to address the complexity of the ISAs? Please take your time and select one of these answers. Okay, and we can see the range there. Again, there is quite a range of responses to this. Over half are no, and a lot are don't know. If you are aware of something in your jurisdiction, if you can please make sure that it is brought to our attention. We have become aware of this as we have started and been undertaking this particular project of more and more jurisdictions. So from our perspective, we would love to get the feedback on exactly what the initiative is in your jurisdiction, and also then try and get some feedback as to how it is working in your jurisdiction. Then we can see if it is jurisdiction specific or if it is something that we should consider at the international level. So thank you for that. Okay, the third area, please. Okay, and this is developing guidance for the auditors of less complex entities or other related actions. And so we're into the guidance area here. And we are looking at a comprehensive guide as to how to apply the ISAs in circumstances where the nature and circumstances of the audit being entity are being less complex. So should we develop a comprehensive guide? Should we develop international auditing practice note for audits of less complex entities? And again, we've had one out there, and should we ensure that is being done? Is there areas where there is a requirement or a benefit coming through from specific guidance, particularly for challenges? again, from our new strategic approach of the IAASB, you will see that we are additionally providing developing guidance. But there's also a limit, or we need some ideas as to where we should direct our attention in those particular areas. The fourth area we've identified there is the focus implementation packs for new and revised ISAs, specifically for audits of less complex entities. So again, we have that particular range there of those implementation packs. Now, before we move on to the next slide, what I do want to say is that these areas should not be seen as we're going to pay attention to one area over the others. We're going to look for the suite of best approaches. So we will continue to work on ensuring scalability and proportionality of the standards. We will continue to try and develop education material with the appropriate partners or encourage people to provide education material in those particular areas. We will continue to talk to particular technology providers as to whether there are technology solutions. We will continue to talk to the people setting the auditing standards, which are seen to be driving a lot of this particular complexity, if that particular complexity is not aiding the quality of the decision making. So as well as working on the first suite, we could look at the second, but it certainly does not count out with the second, which is the developing the separate standard. So one or two might be a little bit mutually exclusive, but certainly it doesn't stop us working on developing guidance. So it's not necessarily A, B or C that we will be doing. We're going to look at what's the best suite from all these things that are under control of the IAASB in order to come up with a solution to this particular issue. Okay, let's go to the next poll question. This is the final poll question, I believe. This is actually asking where you think we should be placing our immediate attention. So even though I have just outlined that we won't look at these mutually exclusive, we'd like to know which one you would like to see us concentrate on. Okay. And again, you can see that there is a range of answers here. The one which people have said they would like to see us concentrate on is 41% on developing a separate auditing standard for audits of less complex entities, 38% on, so very close on developing guidance for auditors, and 21% on revising the ISAs. So there is a range of solutions. This question always promotes some interesting discussions. I must say that when we had the conference in Paris, we put up whether it was going to be a choice of the developing the suite of the ISAs or developing a separate standard. And the feedback which we got from that particular conference was around about 50-50. So as I've gone and talked to different groups, some groups have been strongly supporting the development of a separate standard, and some groups have strongly supported the development of the suite of ISAs. So we need your feedback. We need your feedback on how we should take it forward. We can have a look at that and see why it is that people are looking for those particular solutions. So let's go to the way forward questions, please. Okay, the way forward. So that we need your feedback. We need to hear from all different parts. We need to hear from people who don't usually engage with the IAASB. So please feed it back in a form that we can digest. The deadline for comments to the discussion paper is the 12th of September. And we also have a survey which has been set up by the IFAC SMP, and so the survey will stay open until then. So please respond to the survey, look at feeding us back or feed into your local IFAC member body or whoever it is that usually responds to the IAASB, constituency, and please ensure that we hear from you. The IAASB's working group is set up for this purpose and will analyse the responses. The aim is that we have that in September the 12th. That won't be ready for our mid-September meeting. We'll have that ready for the December meeting, and we will be making recommendations and looking for a way forward for IAASB discussion early next year. We will also feedback, we'll look at the best way of providing you, our constituency, with feedback so that you can see how this project is moving, and we will have a feedback statement which will be published setting out the summary of the responses, views to the discussion paper and the survey. Okay, can I have the next slide? Okay, so our planned outreach activities, and there is an article which has been published on the IFAC's Knowledge Gateway. We have also a number of other references which we have discussed in the discussion paper and have made available to you. So if you wish to have a look at those, for example, to see what a single standard may look like, please refer to those particular discussion papers. We are doing an online survey. We're conducting the online survey on the targeted at stakeholders who would not necessarily respond to our normal consultation. To date, we have over 800 responses, and we're looking forward to receiving many more. I want to break all records as far as hearing from a constituency as to what your needs are in this important area. So please feed it back. There is a summarised article in Spanish, English and French on the IFAC's Knowledge Gateway, and we're doing this webinar also in those three particular languages. We're also developing virtual content to introduce the discussion paper and to promote it further through social media. I'm also aware that many local IFAC member bodies or standard setting bodies are undertaking particular outreach. So please keep in touch with your local member bodies and as to what is being done there, and feed into them, participate in with them on their particular processes. Okay, so thank you. Final slide. So we would love to hear from you. I want to break all records on getting feedback on this important. We need to hear from the particular constituency which has recognised this as a particular issue that the IAASB has to deal with. The better feedback that we get, the more feedback that we get, the more directed our responses can be. So thank you very much for joining us today, and we look forward to hearing from you through our particular process. Good morning and good night. Thank you.
That concludes the session for this morning. Thank you.